a 600 year BC, which was 600 years before Christ, right? And so what was the form of transportation 600 BC?
Can you set up ask a question again?
What type of transportation? How did people get around?
Oh,
600 BC.
Boats, donkeys, camels, feet, yeah. Maybe bikes. I mean, people want to say they have bikes, but
I
understand what you're saying. But remember what Jesus, remember what the Father said. He said, "What?" When we talked about this earlier, he said, "There's nothing new under the sun." So if we have bikes now, they have certain. That means they must have had it, but then in different form. Well, not everything we had, but they had it in different forms. So like that, they had it in different forms.
I think the reference to that was mostly about the end.
Oh, nothing under the sun.
About the end. Can you see that the people see the new man?
Right.
So most of the time it was just walking after.
Walking and donkey. Now we know that the army had chariots in that type of
thing. What is a chariot? What is a chariot? Mm-hmm. What is a chariot?
A chariot, those two wheel vehicles.
Horses.
Drawn by horses that the army used to. Sometimes you see them in the movies.
Yeah.
Right. If they in the movies and whatnot, those are chariots.
Oh.
Okay. So back 600 BC, we find that people did a lot of walking, and they had maybe the donkey that they rode. The army traveled with their chariots and horses and whatnot. So now we have this Daniel and his companions on going to Babylon, from Jerusalem to Babylon. Okay, does anybody know the distance from Jerusalem to Babylon? From what I found in my research, it's 1,678 miles. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine walking 1,678 miles? Okay, the whole army, 1,678 miles.
Where you heard that from?
I looked it up.
Wow.
Okay.
That's deep.
Look it up. So that's how they travel, and that is the distance that you travel to get to Babylon.
Wow.
Okay. Now let me ask you a question. Has anyone ever heard, for example, a group of young people that were in a vehicle and they were stopped by the police, and one of the individuals in the group committed a crime? At that point in time, how many people are getting arrested? All of them.
Say in that time?
No.
Oh, now.
One committed a crime, but they're all victims.
Right. Oh, okay.
They're all victims. Even if they didn't know they're victims. They're all getting arrested. And then when they get to the police station, they're going to sort out what happened. Okay? If they're in the car, they're all getting their victims. This is what happened to Daniel and his companions. They were victims. Okay? So last week we talked about Hezekiah. Hezekiah was a king that was he was sick, and he was going to die. And God sent Isaiah to Hezekiah to tell him to put his house in order because he was going to die. Hezekiah began to cry and to pray. The Lord sent Isaiah back telling him that he would extend his life for 50 years. Hezekiah was healed. That's when the sun went backwards. Remember that? The sun went backwards 10 degrees. The people in the east, okay? What people do we know came to Judah from the east? The Magi. Those people saw the sun go backwards. And the story got back to them as to what happened with Hezekiah. So the Babylonians sent representatives to Jerusalem to see Hezekiah and find out what happened. When they arrived there, Hezekiah was impressed that Babylon at the time was the center of the world. He was impressed that they came to see him. And so then he began to show off. And what did he do? He showed them everything. All the treasure, including the might of his military, the Bible says. Right? And so then God was not pleased with them because he forgot to mention that God was the one who gave him the 50 years.
Amen.
He forgot to testify about the goodness of God. God was not happy.
Mm.
So God told him that those people would come back and take everything that he had, and would also take with them the young men, some of the young men. Do we remember? Do we remember that? Let's go to 2 Kings. 2 Kings chapter 20. Verse 16 and 18. 2 Kings chapter 20 verses 16 through 18. This is just a quick review as to why Daniel ended up going to Babylon.
So Prophet Daniel was in the Book of Kings? Some of his stories?
Yes.
Wow, I never knew
that.
Yes,
the reason why he ended up in Babylon.
Wow.
Okay. Chapter 20, verse 16 and 18. If I can get one, somebody to read that for me, please.
I'll read it. 16 to 18, it says, "And Isaiah said unto Hezekiah, Hear the word of the Lord. Behold, or look, the days come, that all that is in your house and that which your fathers have laid up in store unto this day shall be carried into Babylon, or Babylon. Nothing shall be left, says the Lord. And of your sons that shall issue from you, which you shall beget, shall they take away, and they shall be enunced in the palace of the king of Babylon."
Second Kings 20, verse 16 through 18. Okay. So God declares a prophecy to Isaiah that they would come and take away all his treasure, all that he had laid up, and all that his forefathers had laid up. And his descendants and some of the others would go to Babylon and they would be eunuchs. Okay? So this is what Hezekiah did. He displeased God. Now, after Hezekiah, Manasseh becomes king. Manasseh is the son of Hezekiah. Manasseh also displeases God. Let's go to 2 Kings 21. 2 Kings verse 21. 2 Kings verse 21. 1 through 6. Second Kings 21, verses 1 through 6.
Manasseh was 12 years old when he began to reign, and reigned 55 years in Jerusalem, and his mother's name was Hephzibah. And he did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord, after the abomination of the heathen, whom the Lord cast out before the children of Israel.
Okay. So,
For he built up again the high places which Hezekiah his father had destroyed. And he reared up altars for Baal, and made a grove, as did Ahab, king of Israel, and worshipped all the hosts of heaven, and served them. And he built altars in the house of the Lord, of which the Lord in Jerusalem would I put my name. And he built altars for all the hosts of heaven in the two courts of the house of the Lord. And he made his son pass through the fire, and observed time. And used enchantments, and dealt with familiar spirits and wizards. Wow. He wrought much wickedness in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger. Wow.
This is what Hezekiah said there. First you have Hezekiah who displeased God. Now you have his son that also displeases God. And then God tells him in 10 through 14, and it says, through his servant, the prophet, the Lord said, King Manasseh has done these disgusting things far worse than what the Canaanites did. And with his idols, he has led the people of Judah into sin. So I, the Lord God of Israel, will bring such a disaster on Jerusalem and Judah that everyone who hears about it will be stunned. I will punish Jerusalem as I did Samaria, as I did King Ahab of Israel and his descendants. I will wipe Jerusalem clean of its people, as clean as a slate that has been wiped and turned upside down. I will abandon the people who survived and will hand them over to the enemy. Okay? This is the curse that's pronounced on Manasseh, the son of Hezekiah. Okay? Now, after Manasseh, then we have Amon who becomes king. Okay? He also offends God, and he is killed by his officers. At that point, Josiah, who was 8 years old, becomes king. Now, we know Josiah was a good king. But after Josiah, we have Joab, who also now offends God again. Okay, at that point, he's invaded by the Egyptians. After that, we have Jehoiakim, who becomes president, and that's when they're invaded by Babylon, Nebuchadnezzar. So you see, you have a series of kings in the same family who are supposed to be obedient to God, and they turn out to offend God, displease God. And you see, the original prophecy would have been a conditional prophecy. If they had turned away from sin, God could have forgiven them.